guys, how's it going? It's Height here, and we're back with a brand new first look to the channel. If you are not familiar with this game, it is Valheim, and we recently started a brand new community server for everyone in my Discord who wants to hang out and just play some Valheim. So this is us starting out a new save. I forgot how to play this game. I have played it before, but it's been a while. So there's Kratos there, and look at that, we already got our first level up. This is great. So this is a voiceover that I'm doing on this video because I kind of just wanted to record everything and do like a highlight video every week, maybe every other week, just showing how the progress is going on the server and show people's builds and stuff like this. Anyway, I'm still learning how to hit trees because it's been a while since I played this game, and as you can see, there we go. I got my first little bit of wood. Perfect. We can make a weapon now, and there we go. We've got a wooden club. Perfect. Let's equip that thing, and now we can hit trees a little bit harder. It makes getting wood a little bit easier. And yeah, now we've got some rocks here. The usual progression. We're getting some mushrooms. That is food to regain stamina and energy. So there we go. Ooh, look at this. Our first grayling here. And bam, we have improved our club stats and we got our first resin and a torch. Lovely. Now we find our first boar. Time to make some bacon. Bring home the bacon, so they say. And this guy, he didn't really want to go home with me, but I talked him into it, so here we are. Got some leather, we got some boar meat, nice big juicy ham. Perfect. And now we're finding berries. So if you're not familiar with how the food mechanic works in this game, you basically just pick food, you can eat it, and you're allowed to have three different types of food active at one time. And the more variety you have, the better stats you get, essentially, is how it works. Better quality food gives you better quality stuff, but having different varieties of food is better than one variety of food. So, we're just trying to get as many different types of food going here as we can. It's just basic food right now, but we'll get there. And here we are. I found someone from our server's little building here. And I believe this was Ostrich's bed right here under Hugin. And yeah, there we go. And then around here is Jake Paul's bed, because Jake Paul is on the server as well. This is so... There we go. I unlocked some crafting recipes here. I guess once you use the workbench, it gives you all these crafting recipes. So I didn't actually build a workbench at this point, but just using someone else's was enough to unlock a bunch of stuff. So there we go. Just looking at all the cool stuff I can build here. And really wanting to make that crude bow, but I do not have enough leather yet, so not yet. Now it's like, oh yeah, I guess I can make a stone axe. That's going to make things a little bit easier. I don't have to club trees. And, you know, an axe is just a little bit better than a stick when it comes to cutting down wood, so straight back to cutting wood. There we go. Look at us go. We got to get all this wood together so that we can start building a base. And now it is time to find somewhere to build a house, and this area here just looked so nice. It had this cool little rock formation going here and this big open terrain. I'm thinking we're going to be able to get something cool going on in this area. Just wanting to get a little bit more meat while I'm here. I'm trying to get those last few leather scraps so that I can finally make that bow. It's the struggle is real. But we're getting there. We start fighting over who gets to live underneath this rock. Kratos doesn't think I should get to live there, so he tries to break it, but he's not strong enough. So here we are running along the shore, just kind of scoping out the area. Trying to figure out where we should build. I kind of like this area because I want to be able to build a dock at some point and use it to transfer resources to and from our base. So again, if you're not familiar with Valheim, you can't transport certain resources, most of the most useful ones, You can't transport them through a teleporter. You either have to cheat the game, which is kind of meh, or you have to transport them with a ship. So we're trying to come up with an idea for a port at some point. We can haul all of our stuff back that way, and we'll see what happens. But I'm liking this area so far. Drop me a comment below. Let me know what you think of this one. I'm thinking this area is pretty nice. We can stick a dock way out in the distance over there. Yeah, that way. And I think it's gonna be okay. I don't know. We might build it a little bit farther inshore. Not sure exactly. So at this point, we start building our base. I'm plunking down the crafting table here because you cannot build without a crafting table within a radius of where you're trying to build. And of course, it's dark. It's nighttime and we can't see anything. So the struggle is real. Trying to get some flooring put down and I just can't see. So time to start putting down the flooring and getting some lights set up so that we can actually see where the heck we're working. And we're trying to start with a relatively small house, nothing crazy. Building takes so much wood in this game that starting with a massive building right off the start is not necessarily the best thing to do until you have better tools to get wood faster. So we're starting relatively modest here. Just a little 3x3 or a 4x3. I can't even keep up with where we're at. I think it's a 3x3. And we set some lights up here, putting down that last piece of floor, and then we have to start putting walls. Yes, look at this house coming together. What a beaut. And it's at this point I am out gathering more wood because, as I said, buildings take a lot of wood in this game, and we get under attack. The forest dwellers decide that they don't like us moving into their terrain, and they decide to attack. And being my first night on the server, I was not prepared for this. I had not a lot of weapons. I don't even think I had a bow yet. Or did I have a bow? I can't remember. But it didn't go well, so anyway, after several minutes, maybe 10 minutes of running around, I decide, you know what, these guys aren't going anywhere. Maybe I can hit one. And I get one shot by the brute. This is so, don't try to melee those guys, they're not very friendly, and yeah, they're not a pushover. Anyway, we managed to get rid of them, and here we are back finishing up the house. Got the walls mostly completed. And it's time to get some windows and some doors set up. So there we go. There's not really a tile for windows, at least not at the stage of the game that we're at. So I just kind of used some smaller pieces and left some holes in the wall just so we could have some windows at the front. Here we are setting up some roof pitches. We could have made this thing a little bit taller, but again, we're trying to just stay kind of modest on the first house. Just to get us going. We need a roof over our heads. We need some beds. The basic stuff. Nothing crazy. It's a start. We'll build from here. Don't worry. Not a problem. There it is. The house is done. Perfect. Absolutely perfect. Our first little hut. Love it. And now it is time to put a little addition off the side, a garage, if you will. And we're going to get the crafting table set up. I just got to get a couple poles. I don't need these, but they just make it look a little bit better. So figured, why not? You know, make it functional, make it look good. It's okay. It's all right. I'm not super happy with it, but it'll work for now. Anyway, we don't need this crafting table anymore, so we're going to move it underneath our roof. And then try and keep everything a little bit more tidy now going forward. Ta-da! Perfect. And also, let's slap down some cooking stuff and a fire pit. Just so that we can actually prepare some food. Awesome! We're making so much progress. Okay, there. Now we're getting the bed set up here, and I claimed this one. I'm not sure why, I just wanted it, so it was mine. And there we go. The base is set up. Simple crafting, simple place to sleep, Time to make a flint spear. Time to use flint spear on stuff. And here we go. Kratos is setting up some storage here for us. Just the basic storage. We're going to get a much bigger facility set up at some point. But anyway, I'm out here picking up flint now because I want to make a flint axe. We're going to need a whole bunch more wood. And I think the flint axe is twice as good as the stone axe as for getting wood, doing damage to trees. So I figured it would be best to come out here and get some flint. And while I'm here, may as well smack around these lizards with my brand new flint spear. Why not, right? So these guys don't drop a whole lot. I think the last one drops me a tail, but other than that, they don't drop anything. So not really worth it, but they do get one shot by the spear, so eh, it was okay. And then I find this little hut here, go in there to check for treasures, which there's none, and find this beehive, which promptly poisons me. So I just hightail it out of there. Okay, finally we can make the flint axe and get back to chopping wood, just like we like to do. Okay, I'm just cooking up some food here, and Kratos has named our house. This is the hut. Oh, that was a great name. I definitely approve. It was very good. Okay, and I'm finally able to make my crude bow. I've been trying to do this for so long already at this point. Anyway, we got the bow. It's time to go and get a whole bunch of leather. And I realize before I can do that, I'm going to need some ammo. So I craft up a bunch of arrows and I head off into the wilderness. Well, wait, before that, we start making some leather tunics and leather pants. And that's when we realize we need more leather, because I don't actually have enough to make the helmet. So, equip that stuff, get ready to go, and it's time to go out and hunt some deer. So I line this guy up, think, yeah, headshot, and I need some practice using the bows in this game. Clearly, I am not the best, but I did manage to get it, so perfect. Spent the rest of the night here just hunting deer. It got super foggy, really hard to see, and I found this base where there was a sign saying, I've been trying to reach you about your car's extended warranty. Warranty with an E. I thought about it for a minute, realized I don't need any warranty on my car, and then went back home to finish cooking up all the venison that I got, and obviously lit myself on fire in the process. It's fine. Nothing to see here. But yeah, so anyway, cooking up the food, getting prepared. We want to go and fight Elkthir. Elkthir? I don't even know his actual name. Something like that. The electric deer. We want to fight him. So cooking up food, getting prepared for that. And now I can finally make my leather helmet. Boom. There we go. I've been working so hard for this. Okay. So, equip that, reorganize things a little bit here. I don't like having equipped items all scattered around. And then, guess what? Another attack from the Graylings. I don't even know. This is just crazy. Two attacks in, I think, three nights. It blows me away. But, anyway. We managed to defend them, get them out of here, and all was well. Here's the last of them, and I was super disappointed to know that when you kill the brute, you get two pieces of wood, a stick and a dandelion, or a stone and a dandelion, but it is what it is. Then we spent another day and a day and a half-ish looking for this shrine where you put the sacrifice or whatever you want to call it. It took us a long time to find this place. Not happy about how long it took us. But anyway, we summoned Elkthir, I think. Anyway, big electric deer. If you've never fought this guy before or seen him before, he's like a deer that shoots lightning out of his antlers. And he is not happy that we summoned him. Yeah, so. Anyway, I started out shooting with the arrows. thinking that I would be safer this way. And I mean, I guess I am, but they don't, it doesn't do a lot of damage. So this guy's kind of weak. He doesn't hit you very hard. It's probably better just to run in there and melee him to death. And we kind of did that here. So this is the first guy. We got him, decided to put him down out of his misery. And once we did this guy, we decided, well, we actually figured we didn't know how many of the drops we needed from this guy to make the equipment, so we decided to kill him a couple more times. And I think we killed him 4 times in total. But after the first time, we both went into melee range with this guy using axes, and it is much, much easier to kill this guy. Would recommend using melee if you can. If you're comfortable, you know, go for it. The bow is, it's slow. I think it does a little bit more damage, but it's slow. So the melee is just much faster. Anyway, there we go. We've killed him 4 times. We got all the loot, and we're back at the base to make the antler pickaxe. This is what we needed to be able to unlock the next tier of materials, because I believe you need this pickaxe to mine for the copper and the tin. So there's that. Made a wooden shield as well, because I don't have a shield up until this point. And there we go, doing a couple upgrades with all the stuff that I've found. We now have a level 3 bow and a level 2 shield, and that's that. That is where we're currently at on the server. And yeah, having a great time. If you guys want to join in, then don't forget to join up on my Discord. There's all the login information is there. We can hang out, we can have a good time, we can build some cool stuff. And yeah, if you build something epic and I come over and check it out in my video, then you'll be on YouTube. So go ahead, come in, say hi to us. We're all pretty friendly. Everybody's here to have a good time. So no trolls. Unless it's friendly trolls. But yeah, other than that, guys, we're going to wrap up this episode right there. And like I said, probably going to do follow-up videos just kind of showing where we're at with the server and where things are going, how we've progressed and stuff like that. But no actual let's play of it. It's just going to be stuff like this, highlight reels and just the general overview of where things are at. But yeah, drop me a comment below. Let me know what you're thinking of this video style and this game and stuff like this. And yeah, that's gonna wrap it up for today, guys. I hope you're liking the series so far. If you are, don't forget to leave me a thumbs up on this video. Subscribe to my channel if you're new here, and I'll see you next time.